Hello, students. How are we? You know my name already, okay? So, let's get started. In this video session, we shall talk about inverse of a matrix. Meanwhile, we are going to deal with square matrices, okay? Inverse of a square matrix. And this will be the first video regarding the inverse of a matrix. So that tells you there will be subsequent videos, okay? Please, before you begin this video, it is highly recommended that you view the videos in the playlist. The playlist is matrices and determinants. If you go to my website, www.samuelchukwuemeka.com, you will see, you click on my picture to enter the site, then you click on mathematics, you click on finite math, and then you see the video playlist, matrices and determinants. You need to follow that in order, okay? When we talk of inverse of a matrix, this is a very interesting concept because we use this as we move along in this topic. You will see that the inverse of a matrix is used in a cryptography. So, it's a part of the concept used in the crypto systems. You know, to secure business transactions. Yeah, for secured business transactions. We shall talk more on it when we come to cryptography. We shall do it, and we can talk more on it. So, what is inverse of a matrix? Okay, say matrix A. Okay. 1 is denoted, you can say denoted or represented or designated by A inverse. We write it like this, A inverse. That is the way we write it, inverse of a matrix. Then it is a matrix such that when it is multiplied by A, okay, if it is multiplied by A, or if A multiplies it, if matrix A multiplies it, or if it is multiplied by A, then it gives you an identity matrix, okay? It is a matrix such that when multiplied by matrix A, okay, when you multiply it, okay, it gives an identity matrix. We talked about this, what an identity matrix means. We have talked about it in the first video. So we are gonna look at it. This is what it means, that when it's multiplied by A, so A inverse times A, okay, or if A multiplies it, okay, is the same thing as A times A inverse. This gives you an identity matrix. So that is the concept here, that when we multiply the inverse of a matrix by the matrix, it gives us an identity matrix. Now, this is a very big concept. You know, I talked about why are we learning this, and I mentioned the cryptography. It is used in a cryptography for secured business transactions, okay? Like your credit card, your debit card. This concept is used in crypto systems, which is used to for programming your credit cards and debit cards. Then another importance of this inverse is that you use it to solve linear systems, okay, or simultaneous equations, whether it's 3x3 or 4x4. You could use this method to solve that. It's what we call matrix inverse method. It's one of the methods used to solve linear systems. So this is very important because actually this is the idea. This definition is the concept that you use for that matrix inverse method. Okay? So that is what we mean by inverse of a matrix. Now, how do we find inverse of a matrix? How do we find it? It is found by two methods. It is found using, these methods. We can find it first by a formula, okay? A formula, using formula, the formula, formula method. Or you can just say formula, okay? And the second one, we can also use a row reduction method. Some textbooks will call it a row echelon method. So you can use any of these methods to find the inverse of a matrix. Now, for this video, we are just going to concentrate on the formula method, by formula. That is what we are going to concentrate on. Then in subsequent videos, we can do a row reduction method. And then we can also now do 3x3 matrix. Now for this video, we shall only do 2x2 matrices. And the example that we are going to use is the example that we used in determinants part 1. So if you look at these matrices, these are the matrices that we are used in that video, determinants part 1. So that is the example that we shall use here. We are going to use those examples in that video here, okay? And we're going to use the formula method. Now, if we're using the formula method, we now say that A inverse is equal to adjoint A over determinant A. That's A. You already know this, okay? That's A. Some textbooks will write it like this. A inverse is adjoint A over determinant A, because this is also determinant. We talked about it in the previous videos. So, you know about determinant, but we have not talked about adjoint. We are going to talk about it tonight, okay? Once you find the adjoint of the matrix and you divide by the determinant of the matrix, it gives you the inverse. That's formula method. So let's get started. All right, question one, A is equal to is a 2x2 matrix. By column is 5 2 3 1 by column. Okay, so what is the adjoint matrix? That's another thing. Let's look at adjoint matrix. I'm going to give you the formula, the definition here. Remember, in that video on determinants, we talked about cofactors. Okay, we said that determinant A is A11 times C11 plus A12 times C12. Or you can have it as A21 times C21 plus A22 times C22. Okay, we talked about this. We talked about this in determinants. Okay, now the adjoint is now the matrix of the cofactors. Adjoint A will be the cofactors, the matrix of that cofactors. Adjoint A will be the transpose of the matrix of the cofactors. So this is what I mean here. Look at what I mean. When you find your cofactors, okay, C is cofactors, matrix of cofactors. So let's say that our C, uppercase C, is the matrix of cofactors. And we talked about that, we talked about what cofactors meant. So C will now be, in this case, it will be C11, C12, C21, C22, right? Now, the adjoint, when you get the matrix of the cofactors, cofactor transpose, if you transpose it, we talked about transpose in the previous videos. Okay, when you find the transpose, it is C11, C21, C12, C22. So, this is now the adjoint, ADJ, adjoint of a matrix. So we say that the adjoint of a matrix, say matrix A, okay, number one is denoted. It is denoted by adjoint A, okay, ADJ, adjoint A. And number two is the transpose of the matrix, of matrix A. Okay, that's what adjoint means. So when we find the cofactors, we transpose it, it gives us the adjoint. And then we now divide by the determinant. That's it. Alright, so let's solve this. Let's go ahead and solve this. A11 is 5. C11, remember, 1 plus 1 is 2, so it's even number, so it's going to be plus. Bam, bam. Bam, 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 so that is 1, right? Gonna be bam, bam, that is 1. So remember that this will be plus, minus, minus, plus, okay? Remember this, you need to view that video so you understand what I'm saying. So this is a 1, then A12 is 3. So C12 will be minus, because 1 plus 2 is 3, it's odd. So that will be C12, bam, bam, that is the minus 2. Then A21 is 2, so C21 will be minus, bam, bam, minus 3. Then A22 is 1, so C22 will be plus, bam, bam, plus 5. See that? So let's go ahead and get a determinant. Our determinant, that A, of course, will be A11 times C11. Okay? A11 times C11, 5 times 2. I mean 5 times 1 plus 3 times negative 2. 3 times negative 2. You know, if we had another way to, you know, I showed you a way that is easier. Just multiply this minus this times this. So that's the same thing. Okay. So this is a 5 minus 6, which is minus 1. Or you can have it as, if you want to use the second one, you can say that A is A21 times C21, which is 2 times negative 3, then plus A22 times C22, 1 times 5. And that will be negative 6 plus 5, which is still negative 1. Any of them will work. Okay, that is our determinant of A. This was what we got. This was what we got in that video also. Now, let's go ahead and get the adjoint. So, let me erase this. So before I get the adjoint, I need to get the cofactors, the matrix of the cofactors. So C will be 1, negative 2, and negative 3, 5. That is C. What is the transpose? Okay, adjoint A is equal to C transpose, which is 1, negative 3, negative 2, 5. So I now have that my A inverse will be adjoint A over determinant A, that's A. So that will be 1, negative 3, negative 2, 5, all over determinant A is negative 1. So this means you have to divide everybody by negative 1. You have to divide everybody, every element, every entry, we call it entry, or the elements of this matrix by negative 1. That is what you will do. So this will be 1 divided by negative 1, negative 3 divided by negative 1, negative 2 divided by negative 1, and this is 5 divided by negative 1. This is a, you view the videos that we did on a scalar matrix, scalar multiplication. That's it. Because this is like saying 1 over negative 1. Alright, so this will now be what? What is A inverse now? What do we have as our A inverse? We now have that our A inverse is now what? 1 divided by negative 1 is negative 1. Negative 3 divided by negative 1 is 3. Negative 2 divided by negative 1 is 2. And 5 divided by negative 1 is negative 5. So this becomes our A inverse. That's the answer. Okay. Do we stop here? No. I mean, you've got the inverse of matrix A. But you don't stop here. You want to do what? Check. So you ask me, Mr. C, how do you check? Right. In checking, we check it by the definition. Remember that A times A inverse is the same thing as A inverse times A, and that is I. So you have to use this as check. Use to check your work. So I will require you to use this to check your work. Okay? To know whether you got it right. So multiply A by A inverse. And let's see whether you will get an identity matrix. If you get an identity matrix, yay! If you don't get an identity matrix, you do it again. So let's go ahead and multiply that. So A times A inverse. Okay, remember the multiplication of matrices row by column. Okay, this is a 2 by 2, right? This is a 2 by 2, 2 by 2. And this will be a 2 by, this is also a 2 by 2. So 2 is equal to 2. So it is conformable for multiplication. So A inverse will be what? A inverse will be what? 2 by 2, 2 by 2. Okay? The videos we did on a multiplication of matrices. So this will be row by column, right? 5 times negative 1 plus 3 times 2. Okay? Then 5 times 3 plus 3 times negative 5. You close. Then 2 times negative 1 plus 1 times 2, then 2 times 3 plus 1 times negative 5. So what's this gonna be? What's it gonna be? Let me speak like an American. What is it gonna be? So this will be negative 5 plus 6, and then this is 15 minus 15, okay? Then this will be negative 2 plus 2, and then this is 6 minus 5. What we got? What we got here, folks, what we got here? So we now have that this is 1, 0, 0, 1, which is an identity matrix, 2x2 identity matrix. I subscript 2. It just tells you it's 2x2 identity matrix. So if you like, you put in. If you like, you don't need to put it. If you like, you put it. It doesn't matter. Okay? That's it. So, hey, we got it right. Hey. So this is the inverse. Alright? Let's go ahead and get the rest out of the way. Okay, each one we do, we have to check our work to see whether we are right. Each one we do, we check our work to see whether we are right. We check our work to see whether we are correct by using the definition. Question 2. B matrix is a 2x2 matrix by row 7, 12, negative 2, 5. Now let's go ahead, get the determinant, get the adjoint. So, of course, determinant of B, if we don't want to waste time, okay, we can say that the B is what? 7 times 5. Minus 2 times 12. 7 times 5 minus 2 times 12. Okay, this is a shortcut for it. This is 35 minus 24, which is 35 plus 24, which is 59. So we don't need to write B11 and the rest of them. So let's go ahead and write C11. C11 is plus, bam, 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 5. C12 is minus, bam, bam, minus 2, okay? Which is 2, minus 2 is 2. C21 is minus, bam, bam, minus 12. C22 is plus, okay? Bam, 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 plus 7. Right? So our matrix of cofactors is 5, 2, negative 12, and 7. That is our matrix of cofactors. And adjoint B is C transpose, which is what? 5, negative 12, 2, 7. Right? Now, let's go ahead and so what's our inverse? Let's write in here. B inverse is what? Adjoint B over determinant B. So that would be 5, negative 12, 2, 7, all over 59. So that would be what? Everybody divided by 59. Is that right? Everybody divided by 59. So this is 5 over 59, negative 12 over 59, 2 over 59, and 7 over 59. So what's gonna be our answer? What will be our answer? Oh, this is our answer already anyway. 5 over 59. We can simplify by that. We can simplify. So that's our answer. 5 over 59 by column. 5 over 59, 2 over 59, negative 12 over 59, and then 7 over 59. Do we stop here? No. What do we do?
We check.
So let's go ahead and multiply. And it could be, you know, I told you it could be B times B inverse. And it's still going to be B inverse times B, which is I. That's the special property of, this is a special property of inverse of a matrix. You know that with matrix multiplication, with matrix multiplication, A times B is not the same as B times A. You know that. Matrix multiplication is not commutative. It does not have the commutative property. But a matrix addition is commutative, but matrix multiplication is not. You know, in real numbers, the multiplication of real numbers are commutative. 2 times 3 is equal to 3 times 2. 2 times negative 5 is equal to negative 5 times 2. It is commutative. But with matrix multiplication, it is not. A times B is not equal to B times A. Okay? It's not equal to B times A. Unless B is equal to A inverse. This is the only case. So that's a unique property of an inverse of a matrix. Okay? Yeah, in the sense that if you multiply it, it gives you the same thing. So in the first case, we used B times B inverse, right? So this case, let's go ahead and do B inverse times B. It's still going to give us an identity matrix anyway. Okay? So let's go ahead and do that. So B inverse. Our B inverse is 5 over 59, negative 12 over 59, 2 over 59, 7 over 59. And our B is 7, negative 2, 12, 5. So B inverse times B. Let's do this. B inverse B. So this is a 2 by 2. This is a 2 by 2. So 2 is equal to 2. So this will be what? A 2 by 2. This will also be a 2 by 2. Okay? So let's go ahead and multiply it. So B inverse times B will be row by column. Okay? 5 over 59 times 7 plus negative 12 over 59 times negative 2. We stop there. Then 5 over 59 times 12, right, plus negative 12 over 59 times 5. Okay, we close. Row by column. Then the next one, 2 over 59 times 7 plus 7 over 59 times negative 2. Then 2 over 59 times 12 plus 7 over 59 times 5. Alright folks, what will it be? Let's do this. Let's do it. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
So this will be B inverse times B. B inverse times B is gonna be this is 35 over 59. 35 over 59 plus 24. Plus 24 over 59. You with me? Okay. Then the other one will be 60. 60 over 59 minus 60 over 59. That is row 2, second row, first column, second row, will be 14 over 59 minus 14 over 59. Second row, second column, second row, 24 over 59, 24 over 59 plus 35 over 59. Okay. You know, this is minus times minus, which is plus. So this will give us B inverse times B is equal to, of course, this has the same denominator, so you can add it up. 59 over 59, 0 over 59, 0 over 59, 59 over 59. So this is going to be 1001, which is an identity matrix, 2 by 2 identity matrix.
So we are right.
Okay? Let's go ahead and do question 3. Question 3. Question 3, matrix C is by row 1 over 4, 2 over 5, then 10 and 20. Okay? So this will be what now? C11. Okay, you know I'm using C here. So you can call it C11, small c, you know? It's like small c. Now, this is not the same as cofactors, you know, with cofactors it's gonna be different. So what do we use, folks? What do we use? Let's just use E. Let's use E. So we don't confuse it with cofactors, okay? Let's use E. So we don't confuse it with cofactors. Now, but even with cofactors, you see, you could, you know, you could use that. That's the uppercase, uppercase alphabet. All right, so, no, we use the uppercase C. But let's not confuse it because I don't want you to get confused. So E11 is 1 over 4. C11 will be plus, bam, 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 that's 20. E12 will be 2 over 5, right? Then C12 is minus. Minus what? Bam. Minus 10. E21 is 10. C21 will be minus. Bam, bam. Minus 2 over 5. And then E22 is 20. So C22 will be bam, bam. 1 over 4. Right? So, if you're writing this, you want to make sure that, you know, you double check it to make sure that you're right, okay? Make sure you're right. Okay, what will be the terminal of E? That E, let's use the second one. We can use the formula E11 C11 plus E12 C12. Or we can use E22, we can use E22 times C22. Plus, I'm sorry, E21 times C21 plus E22 times C22. See, many ways to solve something. Many ways to solve something. You use the first row, you can use the second row. Okay? So this is 10 times C21 is negative 2 over 5 plus 20 times 1 over 4. So what are we going to get? Let's use this space. Then E will be 5 into 5, 1, 5 into 10, 2. 2 times negative 2 is negative 4, plus 4 into 4, 1, 4 into 20, 5. 5 times 1, 5. So this is the terminal of E is 1. Oh, that's great. You know, when you have the terminal to be 1. So, because if you divide everything by 1, it's going to be that thing anyway. Alright, now, let's get the cofactors. Cofactors for that stuff, for E. So, the matrix of cofactors will be C11 is 20, C12 is negative 10, C21 is negative 2 over 5, and C22 is 1 over 4. Now, let's find the adjoint E. Adjoint E is equal to C transpose, which is 20, negative 2 over 5, and then negative 10, then 1 over 4. Okay, E inverse is still the same thing, because if you have adjoint E, over debt E, determinant E, you're still gonna get 20 negative 2 over 5 by rho, then negative 10, and then 1 over 4. All divided by 1. Everything divided by 1 will give you that. Okay, so that is the inverse E. Interesting. That's the inverse. But we are not sure. We are not. That is why we need to do what?
Check our work.
So this will be, let's use E times E inverse this time. Okay? Let's use E times E inverse. Let's use that and see what we have to get. So E is 1 over 4 by column 10, then 2 over 5, 20. And then E inverse is 20 by column negative 10, then negative 2 over 5, then 1 over 4. So this is 2 by 2. This is 2 by 2. Okay, this 2 is equal to this 2. So E times E inverse will be what? Will still be what? 2 by 2. Okay? So what is it going to be now? Let's finish that. Let's finish it. We are getting there. So E times E inverse will be, we put a matrix, row by column, right? Row by column. 1 over 4 times 20 plus 2 over 5 times negative 10. You take a break. Then 1 over 4 times negative 2 over 5 and row by column. Okay. Then 1 over 4 times negative 2 over 5 plus 2 over 5 times 1 over 4. You remember, you know, we talked about how you will know whether you're multiplying right. We talked about it in a multiplication of matrices. Okay, this is 1 over 4, 2 over 5, so I have to have 1 over 4, 2 over 5. Then in the second row, you have 20, 20, negative 10. Let's do that. So this is 10 times 20 plus 20 times negative 10. So you have 20, 20, you have negative 10, negative 10. And the other one will be 10 times negative 2 over 5 plus 20 times 1 over 4. All right, folks, what we got here? So this will be 1 over 4 times 20. This is 5. 5 minus, this is 2 times negative 2, 2 times, you know, 5 minus 4. Okay? Because plus times minus is minus. 5 plus minus 4, which is 5 minus 4. Then this is negative 2 over, well, 2 can divide 2, 1. 2 divided 4, 2. So this is a negative 1. If you are confused, give my video on multiplication of fractions. So it's negative 1 over 10 plus 2, 1, 2, 2 plus 1 over 10. Right? Then this is a 200 minus 200. And this is a 5, 1, 5, 2, negative 4 plus 4, 1, 4, 5, plus 5. So what we got here, we have 1, 0, 0, 1. Yay! Which is an identity matrix. Yay! And then you can jump up and touch the ceiling. Okay? That, you know, you got it right. And this is the inverse of it. Okay, we do the last one and then we'll call it a night. And then you can watch out for other parts. Okay? Remember, what we use tonight is formula method, okay? We can still have it. easier way of doing this by using the row reduction method. I know you guys like the row reduction method, right? The last but not the least, question four. We got D to be negative 5, 0, 5, 0. Okay, you know, like I said from the beginning of this videos on matrices, we will be learning more terms, more types of matrices. Okay, more terms, use the matrices as we continue. As we continue solving. So when we did determinants, we talked about a singular and non-singular matrices. Okay, if you look at D now, determinant of D, it tells you straight away that it's zero. Okay, if you do determinant of D, the D, if you use the shortcut, this is negative 5 times 0 minus 5 times 0. Okay, bam, bam, bam. Minus 5 times 0. So this is a 0 minus 0, which is 0. Now, you know, it's of no use looking at, because it's of no use trying to find the cofactors of this anyway, because it's not going to have an inverse. I mean, if you want us to find the cofactors, we can find it. C11 is plus, bam, 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 that is 0. Okay, C12 is minus. Minus 5. C21 is minus. Bam, bam, 0. Minus 0, which is 0. And then C22 is plus. Bam, bam, minus 5. Okay? C11, 0. C12, minus 5. C12. C11, 0, C12, minus 5, okay, C21, 0, and then C22, minus 5. Yeah, but we don't really have any need of this. You know why? You can tell me why we don't have need of this. Okay, this is our cofactors, and then C transpose will be 0, 0, minus 5, minus 5. But guess what? There's no need of this, because guess what? When you come, the inverse of D, the inverse, adjoint D over determinant D. So this will be a cofactor. This is 0, negative 5, 0, negative 5, all over 0. Okay? And this is undefined. Remember, whatever you divide by 0 is undefined. So matrix D has no inverse. Matrix D has no inverse. It does not have an inverse because the determinant is 0. Alright, that brings us to two new terms we will learn tonight. So what we are going to learn tonight now is we're going to learn the two new terms, invertible and non-invertible matrices. So we have an invertible matrix, two new terms. So you keep building your types of matrices. Keep building on the terms or the types of matrices. Invertible matrices are matrices that have an inverse. Matrices that have an inverse. Okay? They are also referred to as non-singular. Non-singular matrices. Yeah, because they have an inverse, because their determinant is not zero. Okay, non-singular matrices are matrices whose determinant is not zero. So if the determinant is not zero, if it's a square matrix and the determinant is not zero, it is a non-singular matrix. And because it is non-singular, it has an inverse. So it is also an invertible matrix. Okay, that's why some textbooks will say invertible or non-singular matrices. Or they will say non-singular matrices or invertible matrices. Now, non-invertible matrices are matrices that do not have an inverse, They are also referred to, as singular matrices. Some textbooks will say singular matrices. Okay? Because singular matrices are matrices whose determinant is zero. And because the determinant is zero, from the formula, if you divide anything by zero, it gives you undefined. Okay? It's not a defined function. It's an undefined. So, because it's undefined, it does not have an inverse. And because it does not have an inverse, it is a non-invertible matrix. Okay? So, we refer to them either invertible matrices are referred to as non-singular matrices, and then non-invertible matrices are referred to as singular matrices. Okay, thank you so much for listening tonight. If you have any questions, feel free to